El Señor es contigo, bendita entre todas las mujeres, Señora eres tú. Bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. María, Santa María, eres Madre de Dios. Ruega por nosotros, ahora y en la hora de la muerte. Dios te salve, María.
For our entrance song, please join us in your green hymnals, number 813, City of God.
Please rise.
Awake from your slumber, arise from your sleep. A new day is dawning for all those who weep. The people in darkness have seen a great light. The Lord of turn into dancing, for the Lord our light and our love has turned the night into day.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you. Good afternoon. Well, today we celebrate the Queenship of Mary. Beautiful feast today, and it is celebrated 8 days before the Assumption of Mary. You remember last Tuesday, we celebrated the Assumption of our Lady. But today we celebrate the Queenship, and it is right to do so, because our Mother, the Mother of Jesus, the Mother of God, is a Queen. And we celebrate it, remembering this, the one who serves. King, Queenship is about the one who serves, about service. As we prepare to celebrate this Eucharist, well, let us be grateful to God because so great a Mother He has given us. But at the same time, we recognize that sometimes we are disobedient, like children sometimes, you know, sometimes we miss the mark and we sin. With humility, we recognize our sins and we ask God for forgiveness and strength. And we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who made the Mother of your Son to be our Mother and our Queen, graciously grant that, sustained by her intercession, we may attain in the heavenly kingdom the glory promised to your children. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Judges. The angel of the Lord came and sat under the terebinth in Ophrah that belonged to Joash the Abiezrite. While his son Gideon was beating out wheat in the winepress to save it from the Midianites, the angel of the Lord appeared to him and said, "The Lord is with you, O champion." Gideon said to him, "My Lord, if the Lord is with us, Why has all this happened to us? Where are his wondrous deeds of which our fathers told us when they said, "Did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt? For now the Lord has abandoned us and has delivered us into the power of Midian." The Lord turned to him and said, "Go with the strength you have and save Israel from the power of Midian. It is I who send you." But Gideon answered him, "Please, my Lord, how can I save Israel? My family is the lowliest in Manasseh, and I am the most insignificant in my father's house." "I shall be with you," the Lord said to him, "and you will cut down Midian to the last man." Gideon answered him, "If I find favor with you, give me a sign that you are speaking with me. Do not depart from here, I pray you, until I come back to you and bring out my offering and set it before you." He answered, "I will await your return." So Gideon went off and prepared a kid and a measure of flour in the form of unleavened cakes. Putting the meat in a basket and the broth in a pot, he brought them out to him under the terebinth and presented them. The angel of the God said to him, "Take the meat and unleavened cakes and lay them on this rock, then pour out the broth." When he had done so, the angel of the Lord stretched out the tip of the staff he held and touched the meat and unleavened cakes. Thereupon a fire came up from the rock that consumed the meat and unleavened cakes, and the angel of the Lord disappeared from sight. Gideon, now aware that it had been the angel of the Lord, said, "Alas, Lord God, that I have seen the angel of the Lord face to face." The Lord answered him, "Be calm, do not fear, you shall not die." So Gideon built there an altar to the Lord and called it Yahweh Shalom. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord speaks of peace to his people.
The Lord speaks of peace to his people.
I will hear what God proclaims, the Lord, for he proclaims peace to his people and to his faithful ones and to those who put him in their hope.
The Lord speaks of peace to his people.
Kindness and truth shall meet, justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from heaven.
The Lord speaks of peace to his people.
The Lord himself will give his benefits. Our land shall yield its increase. Justice shall walk before him, and salvation along the way of his steps.
The Lord speaks of peace to his people.
Jesus Christ became poor, although he was rich, so that by his poverty you might become rich.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, Amen, I say to you, it will be hard for one who is rich to enter the kingdom of heaven. Again, I say to you, it is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than for one who is rich to enter the kingdom of God. When his disciples heard this, they were greatly astonished and said, "Who then can be saved?" Jesus looked at them and said, "For men, this is impossible, but for God, all things are possible." Then Peter said to him in reply, "We have given up everything and followed you. What will there be for us?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, I say to you, that you who have followed me in the new age, when the Son of Man is seated on his throne in glory, will yourselves sit on the 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. And everyone who has given up houses or brothers or sisters or father or mother or children or lands for the sake of my name will receive 100 times more and will inherit eternal life. But many who are first will be last, and the last will be first." The Gospel of the Lord. Thinking in today's celebration, the Queenship of Mary, I was thinking about what Jesus would think about his mother. You know, Jesus was raised up to heaven, he resurrected and ascended into heaven, and then Mary was assumed to heaven as well. Where would Jesus put his mother? Did Jesus love his mother, you know, very dearly, very much, very special place? You know, and I can think about my mom, as I often do. You know, I think my mom, all the sacrifices she did for us and all this. Oh, I would like to have my mom in a very, very special place, because I am grateful with her, because she has been a powerful example for me how to trust in God, how to persevere, how not to be weak in difficult times. You know, and my mom, for me, is a beautiful example. And I would like to have her in a very special place in my life. And if I would have a kingdom, well, you know, to be like the queen, something like that. Much more our Lord Jesus Christ. Much more our Lord Jesus Christ would like that. You know, this beautiful feast speaks about not how exalted is Mary. Look at how great is Mary. She is. She's the mother of Jesus, the mother of God. You know, she's great, but why is she great? One, because God preserved her for original sin, but especially for capacity to make present Jesus to other people. And you remember the visitation, right? The visitation when Mary went to visit her cousin Elizabeth. And Elizabeth, the gospel says, was filled with the Holy Spirit. And because of the Holy Spirit, she was able to recognize the little Jesus in the womb of Mary. How little was Jesus and the womb of Mary? Very little, very little. The fullness of God right there in Jesus Christ, even though he was little. And because of the Holy Spirit, she was able to recognize and then says, "Who am I that the mother of my Lord will come to visit me?" You know, it is Mary bringing Jesus to other people. And by bringing Jesus, bringing joy, because when we see this picture of the visitation, everything is about joy. And all the joy is because God has been great by bringing Jesus Christ, John the Baptist, and because of that, salvation to all the people. You know, the Queenship of Mary is about being humble, being there for Jesus, giving everything for Jesus, because what is the kingship about is also service. You may remember that you are kings too, or queens, right? everybody's because of baptism. We received that from Jesus. Jesus helped us to participate, gave us this gift he has for us to participate in the life of Jesus. We are kings or queens, we can say that, you know. We're kings in our kingship to serve other people, to serve. Dignity, the dignity of the Christian people is about serving, giving up our own lives, you know, sacrifices for the well-being of other people. And that is precisely this, what we admire in Mary, our mother. You know, she's about serving, about bringing Jesus to others, interceding for us. Mary is there, the great intercessors, and we see this in this passage of the Bible in which this wedding in Cana. Jesus was with Mary and his disciples coming to this wedding in Cana, and no wine because there were many people. Some people say that because Jesus brought his disciples and they drank all the wine. Well, it's not true, of course, you know. But I mean, the fact is Mary coming to Jesus. You know, Mary knows very well the heart of her son. That's why she approached Jesus, and Jesus said, "Mother, I mean, that is not my time yet." And Mary didn't have more conversation with Jesus, but she went to the servers and said, "Do whatever he tells you." And Mary knew that Jesus would perform that miracle because of her intercession, because Jesus will not allow that people to be embarrassed because of lack of wine. Mary knows very, very well the heart of Jesus, and always sending, you know, do whatever he tells you. Because whatever he does it, because of this sign, many people will come to believe in him. And this is the joy of Mary. It's not only Jesus, my son, look, perform this miracle for everybody to see how powerful you are. No. For people to believe, not to admire the greatness, the big thing, extraordinary things, but to believe, which is very important. To believe means make ours the life of Christ, to trust in God, to continue striving, to always look at God and not on other people and other situations. It's to be like today in the gospel. You know, today in the gospel, how difficult it is for a rich person to enter into the kingdom of God. Why Jesus saying this? You remember yesterday's gospel, right? This young man comes to Jesus. You know, I want to have eternal life. What should I do? Well, obey the commandments. Oh, I have done this since I was little. Well, now go and sell all that you have. Give it to the poor. And then come and follow me. And you have a treasure in heaven. And the man went away very sad, because he had so many possessions. He was a rich person. And Jesus said, it is easier for a camel to go into the eye of a needle than for a rich person to enter into the kingdom of God. And Jesus says, it is impossible. No, it's not impossible. Some traditions say that in Jerusalem, they have the main gate to enter into the city, which was open during the day. So they went during the day. At night, they closed that gate, and there was only like a little gate in which only one person can go through it if they come late into Jerusalem. So it is said that for a camel to go right there would be impossible unless the camel kneels and it is unloaded of everything that it has. And I like this picture, you know. I like this picture, you know, because the camel usually is loaded with goods. You know, and goods might be richness, might be something important. Unless this camel kneels and it is unloaded, can go through this little eye of this little gate. And that is this what Jesus is saying. A rich can be entered into the kingdom of heaven. Of course, everything is possible for God. He says that, but he has to be unloaded. He has to kneel to recognize Jesus, to recognize the kingdom of God. Richness can become a powerful source to help other people. Jesus said many times in the gospel, you know, spend this money and doing good so you may have friends to receive you when you will go into heaven. Now, our resources can become a powerful means for our salvation. But what Mary said, Mary is like she's totally unloaded. She's totally for God. She's totally for serving other people. She's the one who easily can go through this needle eye for us, for our salvation. You know, so today as we celebrate this kinship of Mary, we want more as a church say, yes, Mary is our queen. Sometimes when you pray the rosary, and the Spanish rosary is more common, we pray the litany of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And there are 13 times in which we call Mary queen. And I will say them very quickly. And so we said, Mary is queen of angels. And we say, pray for us, right? And then queen of patriarchs, pray for us. Queen of prophets, pray for us. Queen of apostles, pray for us. Queen of martyrs, pray for us. Queen of confessors, pray for us. Queen of virgins, pray for us. Queen of all saints, pray for us. Queen conceived without original sin, pray for us. Queen assumed into heaven, pray for us. Queen of the Most Holy Rosary, pray for us. Queen of families, pray for us. Queen of peace, pray for us. You know, we recognize as a church that Mary is our queen because she's always there to intercede for us, praying for us that we may embrace Jesus in our minds and in our hearts, that we may be able to experience salvation, not only when we die, here on earth, experience the protection of God, the peace of God in our lives. As we celebrate this feast, I recommend you, you know, today, spend your day giving thanks to God, because so great gift he has given us in Mary. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Jesus, for having us, Mary, our queen, as our mother too. Amen. Confident in the Lord's mercy, let us bring before him our prayers and petitions for ourselves and for the world.
For the church throughout the world, may the Lord strengthen us in virtue and help us grow in holiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those in public authority, may the grace of our merciful God help them in their service to their people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who suffer from anxiety or depression, may the presence of the Lord bring them comfort and fill them with his peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our faith community gathered here, may the grace of the sacraments nourish our dedication in sharing the gospel with our families and friends. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our beloved dead, may they be welcomed into perfect union with God and all the angels and saints at the eternal banquet. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the special intentions that you hold in the silence of your heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for our Mass intentions today, for the repose of the soul of Sister Cecilia M. Rodriguez and the repose of the soul of Jose Herrera León. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. We continue to pray for rain. We need rain. May the Lord send us the rain that we need to continue our everyday life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
And for those who are suffering because of the excess of rain, right, in Los Angeles and all this area, May the Lord protect them, give to them what they need, those who lost their property, their belongings. May the Lord help them to recover their lives. We pray to the Lord. Merciful God, we ask that you hear these prayers we have placed before you and answer them in accordance with your divine will. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Magnificat, magnificat, anima mea Dominum. Magnificat, magnificat, anima mea Dominum. I sing with all my heart. My spirit leaps for joy. Who am I that you should honor me? By your saving grace, all will call me blessed and proclaim the greatness of your name. Magnificat, magnificat. Anima mea Dominum. Magnificat,
magnificat, anima mea Dominum. Lord, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Wash away my iniquity, cleanse me from my sins. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we observe this memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we bring you our offerings, O Lord, praying to be given strength by the humanity of Christ, who offered himself to you on the cross as the unblemished oblation, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the feast day of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing her glory or virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Gustavo, our Bishop, his auxiliary bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join us in singing our communion hymn, number 774 in the Green Journey Songbook, The Supper of the Lord.
Precious body, precious
Yes.
Having received this heavenly sacrament, we humbly pray, O Lord, that we who reverently celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary may merit to be partakers of your eternal banquet. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Before the final blessing, I invite you to sing in Latin, Salve Regina, probably you know that one, right? In the blue and the green book, you can find it in Pi. Hymn number 485. 485. 485. In the Green Book. We sing in Latin, all right? That is Hail Holy Queen, that is the Hail Holy Queen, but in Latin. So let us do our best and say, Salve Regina, Mater misericordiae, vita dulcedo, espes nostra salve. A te clamamus, exules filii efe, a te suspiramus, gementes et plentes, in a lacrimarum vale. Ella ergo, advocata nostra, y los tuos misericordes oculos ad nos converte. Ecce Jesum, benedictum fruntum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, O dulce. too bad. Not too bad. This is Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy. This is a prayer in Latin. So today, the Queenship of Mary, we recognize her as our Queen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This celebration has ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Please join us in singing our exit hymn.
Your protection against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits that prowl around the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Please join us in singing our exit hymn, number 824, Christ Be Our Light.
Longing for light, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people. Light for the world to see. Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church, gathered today.
Longing for peace, our world is troubled. Longing for hope.